Hello and welcome back to another episode of The History Rescuer. Have you guys ever had a project that you started with all of the best intentions and then you got about 80% of the way through and then had a total lapse in motivation, only for it to then continue to rot in the corner of your room and judge you for like 3+ months? Guess who had that happen to her? So I was recently given, or not so recently really, I was gifted by my grandmother a shirt that belonged to her mother in the 1930s. And it was a little bit beaten up and a little bit worse for wear, but she knew how much I adore and am passionate about vintage clothing and restoring vintage items and taking care of pieces of our heritage. And for me, this item is very special because it is my great grandmother's. The first part was shot in about October, just after my feast rock video was completed, and the last part was shot in the last 24 hours. So I'm actually not going to hold you up for too much longer, and we'll just get straight into the video to show you what I ended up doing. So as you can see, this is the red shirt here. It's beautiful, but it's very wrinkled, and it's got a little bit of aging and wear and tear that would be expected in an item from the 1930s and 1940s. I love this little detail on it where the pocket itself is kind of asymmetrical, so the actual tab isn't straight across. It's really beautiful. And you can see the tag is still intact. It reads Rhythm Blouses, registered. And the buttons themselves are really lovely as well. I think they're Bakelite. First things first, I'll show you some of the wear and tear as well. So there's a couple of little holes just at sort of the right shoulder. But the fabric itself is quite well woven, so it hasn't frayed, which is really lovely. And I think some of that is due to also my nan storing it in a drawer for quite a long time, so it has actually managed to not get frayed by that process. There's one just here at the shoulder. I'm not sure what I'm going to do about that one because it's quite small. It might just require a teeny tiny bit of stitching. There's a couple of little areas that are in need of some TLC, that's for certain. And I'm looking forward to just getting it all. So there's a little bit there as well where the sleeve is coming away. I think it's got some really beautiful bones, so I'm really excited to get something started with it.
My first step when restoring this shirt was to give it a wash, just a good old wash. From what I could see on the shirt, there were actually a couple of underarm stains that had just been left for decades just to sit, and my nan said that she actually picked up the shirt from my nana's house when she passed away, so it hasn't actually been worn literally since that day. And so it was a good idea for me to just put it through and get some of the old funk off the shirt. So all I've done is I've put a little bit of just a really, really simple, eco-friendly, you know, no fabric softener, no nothing, just a really simple soap into here. And sort of rinsed it around. I went with like lukewarm water, very gentle water. We didn't want anything to really be shifting too much out of it. And then just doused the whole thing and gently moved it in the water until it was thoroughly soaked and let it sit for a bit. And then I rubbed my fingers a little bit on some of the more problem areas and then we laid it out to dry. When working with older garments, the last thing that you want to do is warp them. So I actually dried this piece horizontally, not on a coat hanger or anything like that. And I just put it over the top of a very, very old towel that wasn't about to have any color runoff or bleed underneath it. So while I was waiting for it to dry, I actually fixed another one of my shirts that had pulled at the collar. It's a knit turtleneck that is really lovely and it's got a lovely vintage look to it, but I tried to put it on with a towel wrapped over my head while I'd just come out of the shower and the whole thing couldn't cope. So I accidentally tore it along the seam. So that's just what I'm doing here. And Chester was very pleased with a little bit of company. Part of the importance of this project to me was that it is part of my heritage. It's quite literally a piece of my great-grandma, a woman who I never got to meet in life or in person, that I'm able to keep and preserve and restore and actually give a little bit of life to. It's quite a comfort in a way to have that direct link to my personal history, at least. And I also love as well the environmental side of it too, the reusing of this item of clothing that really hasn't seen the light of day in decades and would have long ended up in landfill if it wasn't for my own Nana and her ability to put aside things that are sentimental for future use. I think I've very much got that from her myself. After 3 months in Project Purgatory, I did finally decide to pull this one back out and let it have its time in the sun again. The big thing for this one is that, of course, after its wash, it needed to be ironed again, which took quite a while because I needed to make sure that I did it on a low enough heat that I wouldn't burn the shirt at all, which is, of course, a real problem with vintage clothing. Also, I ironed a lot of it on a pillow and also directly onto my hand because, one, the heat was so low that I could and I didn't end up burning myself too badly. And the other being that there are more complex curves in this shirt than I initially anticipated, especially around the sleeve. It's a really interesting capped sleeve. And so in order to iron it properly, I couldn't use the modern ironing board base to do that. After I'd ironed it, I assessed how it had fared with the washing, and overall it looked really quite good, and so I actually started in on the areas that I had picked out previously to patch and fix. So I started off with the collar lapel, which was fairly simple. I did almost like a whip stitch over the top of it just to try and capture some of those frayed edges and keep as much of the extant fabric there. I chose a 100% cotton red thread that was just at spotlight, which was really quite good. I didn't want to use a synthetic because that would not be of the period really, and I want it to last a long time and to be quite durable. So hopefully we can get another 70 years out of this shirt. After I'd done that, I just did a couple of consolidating stitches sort of in the opposite direction, which helped, and overall it came out quite neat, neater than I expected it to. After that, I did attempt to patch the holes. So there's a mending technique that essentially cross-hatches a new sort of piece of your DIY fabric back between the space. I considered patching it at one point, but ultimately decided that I didn't want to be attaching new fabric to it. I just wanted to try and maintain as much of the extant garment as I possibly could. So I'll put up a photo of the actual technique that I was using. It is a common mending technique for these kinds of garments and also for that particular era as well, which is great. I've never personally done it before, so it was a definite learning curve. And much to my chagrin, it actually looked nicer from the back than it did from the front. So that's a lesson for next time, certainly. It was quite wonderful, actually, when it started to come together. I essentially did stitches, long stitches, all the way across the hole that was vertical. So I ran with the weft, and then I went across the other way going with the warp, and I went in an over-under through the actual individual stitches that I had done previously so that it literally became a new sort of cross-hatched piece of fabric patch through the middle. So it helped to consolidate the actual threads that were already there, and it helped to fix the holes, which was great.